CSS Grid, while amazing, it's quite difficult to understand, and let's be honest, it's incredibly complex. Developers today, myself included, still have a hard time using it without constantly consulting documentation. In this video, I will give you the most straightforward way to get started with it. I won't go into all the nooks and crannies, into all properties and units that are available within CSS Grid, but I will just show you how to set it up simply, and then later on, if you want, you can dive into more advanced topics. But this video alone should give you good enough foundation to get started and to get comfortable with using CSS Grid. Let's see how. All right, in this tutorial, I will show you how to set up Grid using the Grid Template Areas. Grid Template Areas is CSS property that allows you to create grid visually. And I'll show you exactly how right now. So here we have a demo on CodePen. Link is going to be in the description, as always. And HTML, as you can see, is quite a bit straightforward. There's a flat structure here with the header, main, side, and footer elements. And those are the classical elements that you would use to create some kind of a page layout. And this is exactly what we're gonna do in this demo using CSS Grid, or rather using Grid Template Areas. The thing to note here is that we have the layout container and we're gonna define grid on that particular element. So let's jump to CSS. I have a little bit of styling applied to this page, to those elements, as you can see, but we will not go into that. Let's just immediately create CSS Grid on our layout element, which is gonna be right here. We will say display grid. Nothing much happens here because we didn't define how we want the grid to actually look. And the easiest way to do that, in my experience, is to use Grid Template Areas. Grid Template Areas is defined with a string, or rather with a number of strings, and each string you define represents a separate row in the grid layout. To recreate exactly this structure right here, we could write something like string header, and this string can be absolutely anything you want. I'm just gonna name it header exactly as our element right here to make it a little bit more apparent what's happening, but this can be anything. It could be A or B or whatever you want. Let's go with the header for now. Another row is going to be content, and then the last row is going to be footer. We're gonna ignore the sidebar for now, and I'm gonna comment it out, or rather, I'm just gonna set it to display none so it doesn't interfere with our layout here. And here we have created grid that looks exactly like this. We can format it a little bit better so we can see exactly how this looks on our page. And we have our header, content, and footer elements. This right now does absolutely nothing. We still need to assign elements to a particular grid area. Before we do that, let me just set the height of this container to 100% of the viewport because we actually want to have this layout cover the entirety of the page. So height 100, viewport height. And now if we want to assign a particular element to a grid area created right here, and we have three areas created, or three rows, header, content, and footer, we can assign it using the grid area property. And grid area property takes an argument that is specified right here. For a header, we can say header, and this will assign our header element to the grid area created right here. And let's create the grid area for our content and footer as well. We will assign content element to content grid area. And we will assign footer element to footer grid area. And right now, nothing really happens here. But if we were to change our grid template areas, maybe let's add header to the bottom. You're gonna see that our content changes, which gives you a lot of flexibility to work with a single property, grid template areas, and set up the grid exactly as you see fit. Let me return the header to the top here. And if you want to size those elements, because we probably don't want our header and our footer to be exactly the same height as our content, we can tweak those values in our elements. So we could say header height 5 rem units. And this will not work as you expect because we're not actually changing the grid sizes, we're just changing the element height. So what we want to do is we want to define grid template rows. And grid template rows takes as many arguments as you have rows. For example, we have three rows here, so we want to assign value to each row, and we can again format it one line after another so we can see exactly which line corresponds to which row. So our header, let's set it to 5 frames. Then we have our content, let's set it to 1 fraction unit, and I'm going to explain exactly what this is in a bit. And for our footer, let's set it to 5 frames as well. Or let's set it to maybe 10 frames just so we can see a little bit of difference there. And this is already a layout that we've created using CSS Grid. We can tweak those values exactly as we see fit for each row. But what is the fraction unit exactly? Fraction unit actually represents a fraction of the available space. So, for example, we have the first row set to 5 rems and the second row to 10 rems, which gives us 15 rems in total. And this fraction unit actually signifies that this element, or second element content, will fill the rest of the available space. If you have only a single fraction unit specified, that actually means that it's always entirety of the available space. But if, for example, two elements are set with the fraction units, let's set our footer to the fraction unit as well, one fraction, this means that those two elements, our content and our footer, will take exactly the same amount of the available space. So you could view this as percentages, but it's actually a little bit more powerful. If we want our content to be twice as big as our footer, we can say two fraction units. Now we're separating our available space, according to fraction units, into 3/3, and our content is going to take 2/3, and our footer is going to take 1/3. We could also switch our header to the fraction unit as well, and then we would have something like this, where our header takes one fraction unit, our footer as well, and our content is twice as big. Or if we want to make it 5 times as big, we can say 5 fraction units. And you can see exactly how this works and why is this so powerful. We can set exact sizes to our header and footer area, and then we can space out rest of the elements, content in this example, according to the available space. So let's return our header and footer to 5 and 10 rems. And now, since we only have one fraction unit, the number here doesn't play a role. We can have this 1 or 5 or 500. It's not gonna make any difference because we only have one row with the fraction units defined, which means that it's gonna take all available space regardless. So let's return this to one fraction unit. And this should give you an idea how fraction units work. But now let's return to our layout. We have this single column layout, header, content, footer. And if we wanted to add a second column, we could specify the second column exactly in each string. So if you want to add a sidebar that spreads entirety of the page right here, we could say header space sidebar. And this is going to create a second column. The thing to note here is that the grid template areas requires you to have the exact rectangular structure, or you have to have exactly the same number of elements in each row. So if we have two elements in our first row, we're gonna need two elements in our second row and in our third row. So if we want our sidebar to go all the way across the page, we can say sidebar in our second and third row as well. And if you remember, we commented out the sidebar or set it to display none. So let me remove this. And we're gonna set grid area here as well, because grid system needs to know where we want to place this particular element. And we want to place it into our designated grid area called sidebar, grid area, sidebar. And now you see that we have created our second row, and our second row is basically a sidebar that goes the full height of our page. In grid template areas, spaces don't make any difference, so we can actually align this exactly as we see fit, so it looks a little bit better, a little bit cleaner, a little bit more obvious what's happening. Now you know how to create columns using the grid template areas, but what if you want to have only a single column for a certain row? For example, we want our header and footer to be full width of the page and not next to the sidebar. And we can do this very easily if we just specify header here as well. You can repeat elements in grid template areas, and this will actually tell the grid system that you want this element, header, to spread over two columns. So this area right here will be treated exactly as a single unit. And you can immediately see how this works. Same thing about the footer. If we want to have our footer the full width of the page, you can specify this in our grid template areas. And there we go. Now we have our header, content, sidebar, and the footer. And if we want to change the sizes of our columns, because we have two columns now, column with our content and column with our sidebar, we can specify this using the grid template columns property. And again, grid template columns will take as many values as you have columns. So if we have two columns here, we're gonna need two values. And we're gonna say again, one fraction unit for our content, because we want to take as much of the available space as possible. And this already works, as you can see, because our sidebar has only this amount of content, just this text sidebar. So our content will fill the rest. Or if we want to specify it more strictly, we can do something like 20 rems, for example, and let's see how this looks. Now we have a sidebar that takes exactly 20 rems, and the content element, or the first column, is gonna take rest of the available space with our fraction unit. There's a really easy way to add spacing between those columns and rows using the grid gap property. And here you would just specify the amount of space you want to have between those columns and rows. For example, let's say 1 rem. And you can see that our black background is coming through between our rows and columns. If you want to specify only this gap between columns, you can say grid column gap. and just as well, it can specify the gap between rows with the grid row gap property. And let's set it to 2 rows so we can see the difference. And there we go, we already have this really interesting layout that we've created with just a couple of grid properties. And the main thing here is grid template areas, which allows us to create anything that we want. If you want to have empty cells in your grid, you can easily do that by just specifying the dots. For example, maybe we want our content and sidebar to be a little bit centered, a little bit tucked in, and our header and footer to spread the full width of the page. We can do this if we specify 2 more columns, for example. So let's copy our header value here and our footer value. And for our sidebar and content, we're gonna say dot and dot. Dot signifies that we want to have empty space. Now, grid template columns is no longer in sync because we only have 2 columns defined while we have 4 in our template areas. So we're gonna need to adjust that. And let's say we want this empty space to be 5 frames for some reason. We can specify this just by saying 5 frames of empty space here. And here, now our first and last column are sized at 5 rems. And it's not gonna make any difference for our header and footer because those are defined as a single column basically. While we will see the change in our content and sidebar row, because right here we have added empty columns on the left and right. And you can see exactly how this looks. And again, you can format the grid template areas exactly as you see fit. And you can actually use multiple dots here to make this a little bit more aligned. Right here in our grid template areas, you see the exact structure of the grid we have created. So this grid template areas property just very visually shows you how this grid is defined. Then you assign element to those areas created here using the grid area property, like we have here, grid area header, grid area content, sidebar and footer. And of course, those values here don't have to correspond to the selector they're using. And then to size those rows and columns, you can use grid template rows and grid template columns properties, and those are gonna correspond exactly to the number of rows created here, which is gonna be 1, 2, 3, and to the number of columns, which is gonna be 4 in this case. Or if we remove this empty space right here, we can specify this grid as 2-column layout. So as I said, this is all you need to know to get started with CSS Grid. I hope it gives you confidence to start playing around with CSS Grid if you still haven't. And to make sure that you don't miss the follow-up video where I'm gonna go into a little bit more advanced concepts, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in the next grid system, or rather in the next video.